So I sat here a little while ago and I recorded a video just of me breaking down the college football rankings. And as I was recording it and going through it, I realized this is really boring even for me, because I know how boring I can be at times. Believe me, I'm self-aware. And I said, I don't want to put that up. I want to put up something, but I came up with something better to talk about. And it's just how insane it is that the Big 12 has put itself in this position. When you stop and think about it, the Big 12 makes it harder on all 10 of their schools to get to the college football playoff, more than any other conference in college football. Just stop and think about it. As a Big 12 school, you have to play 9 conference games, everybody in your league. And if you can find a way to get through that, you have to play a conference championship game where you have to play the second best team, whoever that may be. And if you can get through that, and if your schedule's good enough and you were undefeated, maybe one loss if you have like a good non-conference like in Oklahoma, maybe you get in the college football playoff. Compared to what other conferences have to go through right now, you know, the SEC, they're split up in divisions, 14 teams. They play 8 conference games. They don't have to play everybody. Look at Wisconsin. Wisconsin's on the fast track to the college football playoff, and I'm sure as hell they're hoping that maybe Michigan State could pull off the upset so that way they don't have to play Ohio State or Penn State. In theory, like, no, nothing against Michigan State, but in theory, that's a more winnable game for Wisconsin. And they would, like, be undefeated, and they would more than likely get in. Washington, hey, let me tell you something about Washington. A lot of people have written off Pac-12, but I'll tell you what. Washington, they play Stanford Friday. It's their last road game. And Stanford may not be ranked, but they're a good team with Bryce Love when he's healthy. And if they win that game, then they got Utah at home, Washington State at home, who's ranked at the moment. And then it's looking like they'll have a neutral site game like in Santa Clara against USC with Sam Darnold, who they're kind of sneaking up back into the top 10 all of a sudden. So don't write up Washington just yet. There's a little bit of chaos above them right now. Chance to get back into this thing. So, and then you got the SEC, who is, this is what drives me crazy about having a championship game. The SEC does it right. Or at least it looks like, let me rephrase that. It's not that they do it right. They are going to potentially get the most out of their conference championship game, more than anybody this year. That's what I meant to say. What they have, they got 2 heavyweights in both divisions just rising up. It's like old pro wrestling. You see, you have the babyface over here, you have the heel over here, and they're just like winning matches until finally you want to see those two collide, like at WrestleMania or something, right? You want to see Hulk Hogan versus the Ultimate Warrior. You want to see that fight. So right now, you know, they're coming to the point where they got to play some of their biggest games against similar opponents too. Georgia's got to play Auburn. Alabama's got to play Mississippi State and Auburn. Georgia's got to get through a rivalry game, but Georgia's punched their ticket. They're getting in there. Can they get there undefeated? We'll see. There's been even talk this season about even if Georgia or Alabama if any one of them lose in the SEC championship, if it's like a great game by some person's opinion on ESPN, they're already making the argument that they'll both get in. You know, that narrative, which evolved from earlier in the year to, well, Alabama and Florida State, you know, they could both get so good. Whoever loses, they could still both make the playoff. And we all know how that turned out for Florida State. But that's when you get the most out of your conference title game. When you have 2 teams in opposite divisions build up, build up, build up, and then you get to see them collide and see what happens. You don't get that in the Big 12. The Big 12 got scared. The Big 12 got pushed around by idiots in the media saying, you need a championship game. The committee said, well, we don't have that 13th data point. Which is funny to me because who is in the top 4 of the college football playoff right now who won't have a 13th data point? Who everyone loves to make the college football playoff if they went out. Let me see, who does that? Oh, you mean Notre Dame, who doesn't play in a conference. Who doesn't have that 13th data point? Oh, but their schedule's really good. Oh, so it's about the schedule. It's not about the number of games. It's the schedule. So the Big 12, they got fooled into this with TCU and Baylor. Because TCU and Baylor did not have, in 2014, did not have good non-conference schedules. Like, TCU had, like, Minnesota or somebody, and that was, like, kind of decent, sort of. But Baylor played utter garbage. Just, like, a bunch of FCS and garbage teams. They didn't play anybody worth a damn. Meanwhile, Oklahoma, the following year, in 2015, went on the road to Tennessee. Now, you can argue whether Tennessee was good or not, but they were like an 8 or 9 win respectable program at the time, and it was on the road in a 100,000 filled SEC stadium, and they won. Oh, and by the way, late in November, they went boom, 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 defeated the top 3 teams in the Big 12 and got into the college football playoff without the 13th data point. So now we have a 13th data point, and whoever wins this game Saturday between Oklahoma and TCU, oh, they're going to have a chance for that 13th data point. These two teams that play this week may have to play again. We don't know. Like, it's just utterly insane. You have no... It is so hard to predict what is going to happen with this, because we're going to... It is going to be chaotic. And I don't know. If any team, whether it's... Like, because really, it's down to 2 to make it. If you're the Big 12, you pray to God, whoever wins on Saturday in Norman, you pray to God they win out. And you pray to God nobody important gets hurt, like a Baker Mayfield or a Kenny Hill or whoever. Because you'll have to look yourself in the mirror and say, we just screwed ourselves. You just screwed yourself big time, especially your marquee program, Oklahoma, who goes into Ohio State, wins, and then, without a defense this year, is finding a way to win football games. Iowa State, who's making a name for themselves. But you're going to have a conference championship game for no goddamn good reason. You are. Because if OU wins out or TCU wins out, there's no need for one. No one needs to play this useless conference championship game. The only time you need to play this useless conference championship game for the Big 12, most years when this is going to happen, is when no one in the conference is good enough to make the playoff. It is the worst idea. And someone's going to come up and tell me, oh, it's about money, oh, they'll get money. This conference is not going to exist in 5 years. So don't tell me about money. And so I've made videos about this before, and I've had people tell me, like, from outside Big 12, you need a conference championship game. You're a moron, and you're dumb, and you don't deserve to have an opinion on this. And with all due respect, if you're an OU fan and you think we needed it because you got scared into it, I respectfully disagree with you. But for the idiots outside who don't pay attention to how this league plays or anything, you don't deserve to have an opinion on this. Because you don't follow this league. This is like ESPN and those idiots like Joey Galloway, Jesse Palmer. Like, you got Joey Galloway calling Rodney Anderson, oh, he's a tight end for Oklahoma. God. So many idiots on this. Like, yeah, like the one thing, like, the only... you know, I'm not going to get off another rant on this SEC network thing because it's going to go off on a whole other tangent. But all I'm going to say is that Greg McElroy is the one smart guy there because he basically said the winner of the Alabama-Georgia game, the loser should not get another shot. Because you're basically having 2 teams play at a neutral site, right? Neutral site game. And you're going to put them back in 3-4 weeks later to play potentially at another neutral site. Like, you need to see it again, right? You need, oh, we need another neutral site in another part of the South or in Southern California to find out who's better, Alabama or Georgia. Give me a break. So, that's really what I was about to get off on. But, like Booger McFarland's a moron. Jesse Palmer's a moron. David Pollack is a meathead. Joey Galloway's the worst of all. Don't get me started on Heather Dinich. And her mansplaining how the college football playoff works. Jeez. Thank God you're here, Heather. How would we ever figure out how the rankings work? What numbers 1 through 6 mean? Jeez. Anyway, I'm done ranting for the night. And I think the Big 12 potentially will screw itself. If it's not this year, it will be either next year or the year after that. At some point, this will screw someone over. And we will all talk about retroactively what a dumb idea idea it was when everyone else is saying, well, they're going to have the 13th data point. Because I know who all said it. I'm going to be prepared for this. All those morons out there on the media said, they got to have one. You got to have a championship game. We'll see how this turns out. Hopefully, one of the two, whoever it is going to win out. Because that's what I'm rooting for at this point. Like, I can accept it if TCU comes and Norman wins, because they're a good football team. But I hope they win out. I do. I hope they do. Unless it's Oklahoma getting another shot, then I'll root for my team. God bless them. But it'll just be like, it'll be what could have been, you know? It'll be a what could have been type of moment. Anyway, I'm done. Y'all have a good one, Boomer Sooner. And I might pop back on one more time. If not, I'll see you again on Saturday after the game, and we'll recap what happened. Later.